Hello everyone. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about the operation of clipping and clamping circuits. In first part of this video lecture, I want to talk about some theory of clipping and clamping circuits. And in the last of this video, I will demonstrate the experiment related to clipping and clamping circuit. So, what is our object in this experiment? Our object is to study the diode applications in clipping and clamping circuits. And for making a clipping circuits, we need a function generator that can generate a AC signals for us, a oscilloscope by which we can compare our input and output signals. A DC power supply, breadboard, diodes, and resistor. And for making a clamping circuits, we need a function generator, oscilloscope, DC power supply, breadboard, diodes, and capacitors. And now, what is a clipping circuit? Or what is a clipper? Clippers are diode circuits that can be used to clip off the desired portion of input signal. They are also known as limiters or slicers. And a clipper is used for limiting the amplitude of the input signal to make sure that the signal will be within the desired range of the voltage. And there are two types of clippers, first series and parallel. And what is series? When we measure the output in series with the diode, we call it as a positive series clipper. And when we measure the output in parallel to the diode, then we call it as a parallel clipper. And there are two types of series clippers, that is positive series clippers and negative series clippers. In a similar manner, there are two types of parallel clippers, positive parallel clippers and negative parallel clippers. And what is positive clipper? A positive clipper means we are clipping off the positive half of the input signal. And negative clipper mean we are clipping off the negative half of the input signal from the output signal. And first I am going to discuss about what is a positive series clipper. In a positive series clipper, we measure the output in series to the diode. And when we apply a AC signal during first half of the signal, that is positive half, this diode is going in reverse bias condition. And in reverse bias condition, a diode is acting as an open circuit. So open circuit means there is no connection between this part and this part of the circuit. And when we measure a voltage across this RL, since this circuit is not complete, we are getting a zero voltage against this RL. So in this way, we are clipping off the positive half of the input signal. So we call it as a positive series clipper. And this is similar to the half wave rectifier. And during negative half of the input signal, this diode is going in forward biasing condition. And we know that in a forward biasing condition, a diode is acting like a short circuit, or this diode is just like a connecting wire. Now this circuit is complete, and when we measure a voltage across this RL, we are directly measuring this voltage or this signal. So we are getting a signal related to the input in the output. So here we can see we are clipping of the positive half of the input signal and we are not clipping the negative half of the input signal. We can also apply a bias voltage VB in series with RL, and due to the application of this VB, when we applying a positive signal to this diode is going in reverse bias condition that acts like a open circuit, and when we measure a voltage across this output points, we are now measuring the voltage VB. So we are getting a voltage which is equal to the VB of this battery. So in this way we are getting sub signal with respect to the positive half of the input signal. And there is no alteration in the negative half of the signal. And in negative series clipper, we are clipping of the negative part of the input signal. In a similar manner, when we applying a positive half of the signal or a positive cycle, this diode is going in forward biasing condition, and for this diode is acting like a simple connector. So we are measuring this voltage across the RL. So in this way we are getting a positive cycle in the output. But when there is a negative half of the cycle or when we apply a negative signal, this diode is going in a reverse bias condition, and we know that in a reverse biasing condition a diode is simply acting as a open circuit or acting as an open circuit. So we can see now this circuit is not complete and we are getting nothing in the output. Similar to the earlier case, we can apply a voltage VB in series with RL, and due to application of this voltage we are getting some signal in the negative half of the input signal. Now I'm going to discuss about the parallel clipper. First, positive parallel clipper. As I explained earlier, in parallel clipping circuit we measure the output voltage in parallel to the diode, and in a similar manner we can understand the application of this clipping circuits. Here we are clipping of the positive half of the input signal. That is, when there is a positive half of the cycle, this diode is going in forward biasing condition, and we know that in a forward biasing condition a diode is simply acting as a short circuit. So when we are measuring voltage across this voltage, we are getting nothing because there is no potential difference between this and this point, so we are getting zero voltage. But when we applying a negative signal or in the second half of the input signal, that is negative, this diode is going in reverse biasing condition, and we know that in the reverse biasing condition a diode is acting just like an open circuit. So now this diode is not connected in the circuit, and at the output points we are directly measuring the input signal. So we are getting a signal which is similar to the input signal in the output. So here we are clipping of the positive half of the input signal. Similarly, we can apply a voltage VB in series with the diode, and by application of this VB we are getting a voltage during positive half of the signal. And in negative parallel clipper we are clipping of the negative part of the input signal, and we in forward biasing condition in during positive half of the input signal, this diode is just acting as an open circuit. Now this diode is not in the this diode is not a part of this circuit. So we are directly measuring this input signal, or we are getting a similar signal in the output as we applied in the input. But during negative half, this diode is going in forward biasing conditions, and we know that in forward biasing condition a diode is simply acting like an short circuit. So we are getting nothing in negative half of the cycle. So we are clipping off the negative half of the input signal. In a similar manner, we can apply a VB in series with the diode, and we are getting this voltage in the output during the negative half of the signal. And we can make a clipper that can be act as a positive or a negative. And for this we can use two diodes in parallel, and we can apply two biasing voltages VB1 and VB2. And as I explained earlier, now we can clip off both positive half of the input signal and negative half of the input signal. And if we apply some biasing to this diode, we can get this biasing voltage in the output signal. Now, what are clampers? Or what is a clamper? Clamper is a diode circuit that can be used to add a DC level to an AC signal. It is also called as a DC restores. As I explained earlier, a clamper can be made by using a diode and a capacitor. There are again two types of clampers: positive clamper and negative clamper. Positive clamper means if we are taking the output signal, or if the output signal is shifted upwards. And negative clamper means the output signal is shifted downwards. So this is a positive clamper. Here we are taking the output in parallel to the diode, and here I am using a square wave signal. During negative half of the signal, this diode is going in forward biasing condition, and since we are measuring voltage across these points and there is no potential difference between these two points, so we are getting nothing, or we are getting a zero voltage in the output signal. But during this period, this circuit is completed. So during this negative half of the signal, this capacitor is getting charged. So in the next half of the input signal, that is positive half, this diode is going in reverse biasing condition. And we know that in reverse biasing condition, a diode acts as an open circuit. So now this diode is not in the circuit, and we are measuring the potential, which is equal to applied potential and the potential on the capacitor. So we are measuring just double of the input signal, and here we are getting the (clears throat) output signal that is shifted upward. And for making a clamper, the time constant of capacitor is very important. In a similar manner, as we added some VB potential or biasing potential, we can apply this type of voltage in a clamper in the series of the diode, and by applying this biasing voltage we are getting some signal during negative half of the output signal. In a similar manner, we can make a negative clamper. In negative clamping circuit, the signal is shifted downwards. When we are applying a positive half of the cycle, this diode is going in forward biasing condition, and we know that a diode in forward biasing condition is just acting like an short circuit, and we are getting nothing in the output. But during this period, this capacitor is charging, and during next cycle, that is negative half of the input signal, this diode is acting as an open circuit. So this time we can measure the potential which is across the capacitor, and as we applied, so we are getting a shifted signal in the output. In a similar manner, we can apply a biasing voltage VB, and we can get this voltage in the output signal. These are some applications of clippers and clampers. First, application of clippers. They are frequently used for the separation of synchronizing signals from the composite picture signals. The excessive noise spike above a certain level can be limited by using a clipping circuit in FM transmitter by using the series clippers. For the generation of new waveforms or shaping the existing waveforms, clippers are used. Clippers can be used as voltage limiters or amplitude selectors. These are some applications of clampers. The complex transmitter and receiver circuitry of television clamper is used as a baseline stabilizer to define sections of the luminance signals to preset levels. Clampers are also used as direct current restores, as they clamp the waveforms to a fixed DC potential. These are frequently used in test equipment, sonar and radar systems. For the protection of the amplifiers from large current signal, clampers are used. Clampers can be used for removing the distortion, for improving the overdrive recovery time, clampers are used. Clampers can be used as voltage doublers or voltage multipliers. And now I am going to demonstrate the experiment of clipping and clamper circuits in our laboratory. This is our circuit board for clipping and clamping, and we can see there are two diodes D1 and D2, and there are two switch S1 and S2. By using switch S1, we can connect this diode D1 to the circuit, and by using switch S2, we can connect this diode D2 to the circuit. This is our function generator. This is our oscilloscope, and I am using a frequency of 1 kHz with a sine function, and the output of the function generator I have connected to input of this circuit. At the same time, I am connecting this input to the
channel 1 of the oscilloscope, and I am using this signal for reference signal. And the output of this circuit I have connected to the channel 2 of the oscilloscope. And when both the switch S1 and S2 are in off condition, then we can see that there is no difference between input and output signals. But when I am switching on the switch S1, now diode D1 comes into the circuit, and we can see that for positive half of the cycle, this diode D1 is going in forward biasing condition, and for positive cycle, by theory, there should be no output signal. So here we can see there is no output signal. And when I am switching on the switch S2, now the diode D2 is going into forward biasing condition in negative half of the cycle. So from here we can see that these two diodes D1 and D2 are cutting or clipping off the both positive and negative half of the signals. And in oscilloscope we can see that there is no signal for positive half cycle or negative half cycle. And by using this VB positive or VB negative, we can add this voltage to the output signal. So when I am giving this VB positive, we can see there the output signal with respect to the positive signal is increasing. And when I am giving this VB minus VB voltage, the signal with respect to the negative signal is also increasing. So in this way, by using two parallel diodes, we can clip off both positive and negative half of the AC signal. In a similar way, we can use the clamping circuit. And by switching on both S1 and S2, we can clamp these VB positive and VB negative voltage to the output. And when there is no VB plus or VB minus, we can see there is clamping of the output signal.